tonight we are honoring nine remarkable individuals as unsung heroes. These are people that really do not seek the spotlight. They don't look for accolades. The things they do for the community and for others comes from their heart. That's the definition of an unsung hero. In fact, we've got them sitting up here in front, captured so they can't leave, because we're going to honor them. And it's a wonderful thing for us to honor you, your friends, your family, the community to be here, because you're our inspiration. You are our role models. You show us that we can be greater than we are. We're doing this for you, but we're really doing it for us. So, congratulations. Thank you for being here.
I would like to begin by telling you about the COAST program, which stands for Chabad or Atid Sunday Torah. The 11-year-old's connection to the Jewish community comes from the six unsung heroes: Ilan Beskir, Sarah Lavin, Ari Rosenstrup, Zoe Tabachik, Shira Weissman, and Rachel Zuner. This group of Washington University students volunteers each week to help children with special needs, such as Down syndrome or autism, to connect with Jewish learning through COAST. The goal of COAST is to provide Jewish children with special needs opportunities for Judaic learning in an appropriate environment. The weekend sessions allow the students to partner with individual children to participate in games, songs, and other activities centered on Judaic themes.
Marshall Cohen. Marshall is the founder of Look for Life Academy and Gym. He thought, wouldn't it be fun to have a gym and get kids off the streets? Marshall set up Look for Life as a nonprofit gym. Marshall said, we got our first board of directors and it was really good. So good, in fact, that we watched the kids grow stronger and often more self-confident. Still, Marshall couldn't overlook their hunger pains. Soon, he was roasting hot dogs for the kids and driving them home. With many of the gym kids struggling academically, Marshall got another idea. Carla Cohen wrote a school charter, and in 2000, the nonprofit Lift for Life Academy, an independent charter school, opened its doors. 8 years later, they added a high school. And earlier this month, the academy graduated its first senior class.
Samantha Lurie, the energetic Lurie, works before school, after school, and most weekends, trying to make life better for young people. Since August 2008, she has taught students with special needs at Bashan and Roosevelt High Schools. Samantha has served as a mentor for more than 150 students working to improve their academic performance, and she coaches girls basketball. She joined Teach for America, which assigned her to Bashan High. Lurie said, I knew then that becoming a teacher, I would have an opportunity to inspire students to get a great education and to be an advocate for them. Lurie also sponsors students who take part in cultural leadership, a program that rekindles the historical alliance between Jews and African Americans. Lurie decided to raise $50,000 so she can take 25 students to Costa Rica in 2013. She helps run a football camp that combines football with academic training and professional skills development. And not surprising, Samantha runs marathons in her spare time.
Marion Lipsitz. Marion has a deep and treasured history with the St. Louis chapter of Hadassah. She has been a life member since 1942 and has been a past president. She serves as the chapter's representative to the Jewish Community Relations Council and currently sits on the board. Marion is a docent at the Holocaust Museum and Learning Center and has been active in numerous community organizations. She is the former membership director at the JCC, where she worked for 43 years. The couple lost their 46-year-old son to multiple sclerosis in 1993. When he was first diagnosed, she and her husband started a support group for people with MS, which met monthly. The group grew so large that they had to move it into a church. Marion and her husband established an environmental fund memory of their son.
Lurie Opinsky. For Unsung Hero, Lurie Opinsky, making a difference in the world at large is also about making a difference much closer to home. One that affects his daughter. Lurie said, I grew to understand that I had the time and ability to affect change, and if I can help the whole state become better at how it views people with disabilities to create a better quality of life for them, then my daughter's life will also be better. Lurie's daughter, Lily, has Rett syndrome, a genetic disorder generally considered to be a form of autism. Like many who live with the condition, the 12-year-old is nonverbal and uses a wheelchair. Lurie is heavily involved in trying to make the community more accessible and accepting towards those who live with disabilities. He is chair of Missouri Protection and Advocacy Services, a group which helps to preserve the rights for the disabled and provide a voice for their interests. In addition, he is a former president of the Parkway Parent Advisory Council for Children with Disabilities. Currently, he serves as vice president of the organization, which works with the Parkway Administration and the Special School District on behalf of special needs students. He worked with others last summer at Congregation B'nai Amuna to revamp aspects of the synagogue, making it easier for individuals like Lily to play an active role in congregation life.
Stephen Rosenblum, professionally, Stephen assists individuals who want to help secure the future of a world-class St. Louis Zoo, where he has headed the Play and Gifts program since 2005. He serves on the board of the BSKI, co-chairing the Create the Jewish Legacy program. And for more than a decade, Rosenblum has served on the board of Crown Center for Senior Living. Says Rosenblum, I love connecting people, finding an organization with a need, and then finding somebody I know who would have a passion for that organization. Stephen is immediate past president at Crown Center. When he first joined the board, no one had done any outside fundraising or initiated big campaigns. Says Stephen, right away, we started the Friends of Crown Center and are now raising $70,000 a year. Rosenblum is also involved with Hanley House, a historic home through the Clayton Century Foundation. Oh, and in his spare time, Stephen grows vegetables in his backyard. He is founder of the Clayton Community Garden along with 20 other families.
Nancy Schmidt. Nancy is an attorney, and for the past 15 years, she has worked with the GOALS program, which stands for Gateway Older Adult Legal Services. It's sponsored by the local chapter of the American Jewish Congress. She provides free legal services to low-income elderly people of all races and religions through this program. Nancy deals with everything from debt collection practices to legal issues with children to concerns people have with estate planning. She also does periodic presentations on drafting wills, creditor issues, and landlord-tenant issues. These talks help educate people that these are legal issues, and if GOALS cannot help, Nancy will refer clients to state agencies or elsewhere to make sure that their problems are addressed.
Pat Simons. Pat grew up understanding the value of education and the pleasure of reading. She has passed on her love of reading and fostered literary skills in tens of thousands of children in the metropolitan area through Ready Readers, a nonprofit program she founded with three friends in 1997. In the current school year, 52,000 new children's books have been handed out to underprivileged youngsters. Close to 340,000 books have been distributed since the program began. As of March, 472 volunteers were reading each week to nearly 8,000 children in early childhood centers. For 13 years, Pat has served as executive director of Ready Readers.
Joy Sterneck. As a teenage candy striper, Joy fell in love with the field of physical therapy and later earned a degree from Washington U. We were always taught to look for abilities as opposed to disabilities, she says. I learned so much from everybody I ever worked with in terms of courage. Observing such determination gave her a perspective St. Louis U, where Sterneck later received a master's degree in health administration, she served as director of physical medicine and lectured on pediatric physical therapy. Today, as a semi-retiree, Sterneck has converted potential downtime into stepped-up hours as a volunteer. For the Parkway District, she teaches English as a second language to adult immigrants and refugees. And the list goes on. Joy tutors students at Claymont Elementary, is an active member of the Board of Cultural Leadership, assists on the Mitzvah Court Center Reform, is a school liaison for the National Council of Jewish Women Kids Community Closet, volunteers at the Sal Mirowitz Jewish Community School, and has served on the Jewish Fund for Human Needs Committee. And in her spare time, she is quite a talented tap dancer.
Representing Coast, Hannah Novak. Hannah, if you'll come up and receive the award for the Chabad or Atid Sunday Torah. Marshall Cohen. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you our Unsung Heroes.